Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, or evening. Welcome back to the William Nix Center. For those of you who have just chosen to check in to see exciting Panther basketball here in the William Nix Center. Man, what a barn burner for the Lady Panthers. Just couldn't get it done down the stretch, though, man. What an exciting game. 68-75. The Lady Panthers, man, did it big here in the William Nix Center, man. I tell you, just some great play. 21 points led by Ryan Payne. To lead all scorers, and Aaliyah Fontenot with 17 on three huge three-pointers, pretty much, that sent them over and won it for the Jaguars of Southern University. Man, the Lady Panthers played just an outstanding game. Limping, though. Kayla Smith not there. Waddle not playing. Desiree Lewis not playing. Three of their super people not playing today. So I tell you, they had it tough, but I tell you, they really stayed in. Maya Williams played a great game. I thought Amaria Williams is really, really coming on. And hopefully we'll get a chance to chat about that with Jeanette Jackson or Coach Danny Evans as we get ready to get this one underway. For those of you who are watching us on our stream on the Prairie View A&M University YouTube channel, all you got to do is tell a friend to tell 10 friends to tell 10. And that's just one of the best videos I've ever seen done here at Prairie View A&M University. They did a fantastic job with the videos here. Kudos to the athletic department, Coach Alicia Pete, and our AD for getting the lights and everything fixed so that they can go out and come back on. Traditionally, it took about 3, 4, 5 minutes to get this to get the lights to come back on. We couldn't turn the lights on and off. We had an old breaker. And we couldn't get it back on. However, the Panthers have got it really nice here. The game day experience here at Prairie View A&M University is just fantastic. So you got to get here and just check out the game day experience here at Prairie View A&M. Let's go ahead and tell you about the starters. For the Southern Jaguars, starting at guard, a junior from Melville, Louisiana, Derek Tezano. He's a junior. Starting at the other forward is going to be a senior from Biloxi, Mississippi, Jarian Wilkins. At the other guard is going to be a redshirt senior from Laplace, Louisiana, Brandon Davis, Tijon Jumasi will get the start at guard. He's a junior from Paris, France. And also Delang Moon from Frankston, Australia. Delang Moon. I got to get that one right. Been practicing it all week. Of course, for the Panthers, getting started, guard's going to be Charles Lane Jr., the graduate student from Eatonville, Florida. Brian Miles, the big man in the middle, leading everybody in rebounding in the Southwestern Conference, averaging 18 rebounds per game. Brian Miles, is it 18? Let me check and make sure. Miles. Let's make sure of those before I put that out there. Let's see. Miles, where are we at? Here we go. Brian Miles averaging, well, it's 9.5, but he's getting more like 17 against Florida A&M, 16 against Bethune-Cookman. So he's doing pretty good. So we're not going to even worry about that. We're going to keep him going. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the Panthers getting ready to get this one underway here. Getting ready to jump it off. Moon getting ready to jump it off with Brian Miles. And here we go, 20 minutes. And the Panthers are going to control it. Nope, they're going to send it back on the right side to Zano. We'll get into the hands of Diamasi. Right side. Jumasi has it and loses it and will stay down on this side of the ball, ladies and gentlemen, on the Panthers. Yes, ma'am, I'm turning it off right now. Oh, wow, that's a good picture there. Jumasi again with it. Brings it and runs right over Nunley, the Alley Cat. Well, we got a brand new name for Nunley. We're calling him the Alley Cat. And here are my special Mardi Gras beads here. Leslie Le Monton Roulette. And quickly coming in for the Jaguars is going to be Anton Jacks, a junior from Greenbelt, Maryland, and Jumasi. will come in and get a chew from head coach Kevin Johnson. And Kevin needs to sit down. Here we go. Nunley finds a hole for two. Well, looks like we're going to have some colorful coaching today. Here we go, right side. David brings it to the top of the key. We kick it left side. Fading away from five is five. Wilkins. My grandson. They just here. Y'all got subs. Here we go. Over here to Antoine Jackson. Sorry, I was talking to the boss. Right side and up and under. Brian Miles with the defense and the attack, and a foul called on Miles is first. Here for the Panthers. All right, folks, if you want to watch the game, that's my time. If you want to watch the game and see the video, you got to go to the Prairie View A&M University YouTube page, Prairie View A&M Athletics. You can get the play-by-play. You get all the commercials and the music and all of that stuff here. Here it's kind of hard to hear me, but we appreciate everybody who has joined in and watched the game here. And I really want to appreciate my team here, my whole team of Mia Greer, all of her. Doing a great job for us here. So proud of Mia working on those straight A's here at Prairie View A&M University. We are just so tremendously blessed, first of all, to have her, and just so honored that she would do such a good job here at Prairie View and make us all proud. Nunley, the alley cat, loses the ball, and the Jaguars go up by 3-2 to score. Lane in the middle over. Oh, great pass down by Nunley. Nunley has been playing really, really well. Nunley, McCaskey, Hopkins, and Horton are our point guards, and they've been doing a great job. We've only really got, folks, if you look at it, I was talking to some of the alums about, and it falls in for Charles Lane in the three-point player. You know, we've only got really one big, and that's Brian Miles. We had three other bigs who, some things happened. We didn't get them. They didn't come. Let's just put it. One of them got hurt. The other one just didn't make it, and the other one just decided that this wasn't the place for him. But we had three bigs off the on the roster here at the beginning of the year. Just, gee whiz, it's just the way things go. Brente Noel hits it as Jack steals it away. And now 6-5, the Jags up one in the corner, wide open for three off the back of the iron, and the Jaguars all over the back. He's all over the back of the Jaguars, of the Panthers there, was Derek Tizano. And now the Panthers down by three. Here comes Charles Lane Jr. Was that Lane or was that four? Yeah, that's Smith. Charles and Charles in charge. Lane is a fifth, and Smith is a fourth, or junior and fourth. Lane is a junior, and Charles Smith is a fourth. Wow. Nunley up top left side, gives it over now. Here he comes, puts it up, and he's going to be fouled. Going straight to the bucket is Charles Smith. And now in the game, checking in, sneaking in on us is Javonte Horton, the point guard with super-duper hops. He can really jump. Smith will be at the free throw line, shooting two. Early into the first period, 8-5. Smith at the line to try to cut the lead to one. First shot is away. And it's good. Want to send a shout out to Bishop. Donnie P, checking us out. Donnie P, I thought you'd be here by now. Second shot is away. It's the front of the iron. No good. Snatched down by Derek Tizano. And the Panthers We'll go back on defense. Antonio Jack's back up top. The Panthers in the full court press. They break it easily. Or half court press. Dung. Oh, wow. And nice shot there by Antonio Jacks with an easy one right up the bucket. Nunley. And something's going on over there. And Smith is chatting. Something's going on over there. What are the officials talking about? What's going on? Shot clock. Shot clock. Somebody stepped on the court there. Got to be careful. 21 seconds on the shot clock. They're just adjusting. It's 16:42 left to play here in the first, folks. Nunley, the alley cat, comes left side. Puts it back up. Hopkins has it. Now working on Jacks. Takes him to the left side. Takes him to the right and a push. And Horton. Whoa. Gee whiz. That, he wasn't playing there, was he there, Mia? First foul on the floor. Up off the bench coming in for the Jaguars is Jalen Reynolds. Jalen Reynolds from Datlin, Georgia. Datlin. Where in the world is Datlin, Georgia? Right side with it, Smith. Gets it to Lane. Lane from 20. Puts it up for two. Yeah. Lane with a nice 15-footer. 10-8. The Panthers down two. Jacks brings it left side. Nunley on him like a glove. Reynolds at the top of the key wants to work. On Miles, to give it back to Jack's left side. Wilkins kicks it down low, gets it in to Brandon Davis. Davis for two. Nunley brings it left side, finds a corner, puts it up, has it thrown, blocked away. Good job. I mean, great. Move to the bucket by the alley cat. And here we go, right side, Wilkins to Reynolds. Reynolds almost loses it. Tries to get it back to Jacks on the right side. Here comes Wilkins again, and oh, man. And boy, I tell you, man, what a hard foul there by the Jaguars. Stick around, folks, 15-21, first media timeout here. Stick around. This is exciting Panther basketball on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network. Don't you know that it's time to get on board?
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. 15-21 left to play here in the first half. 12-8 to score. I want to say congratulations to my brother, Garland Coleman, who has retired from UPS after 37 years of working at the United Parcel Services. And his get down will be tonight, and I totally forgot about it. I'm in big trouble. Here we go back to live action, right side. McCaskey has it, who's just checked in along with Horton. Now we got the quick guards there. Oh, Lewis almost loses it. Miles gets it back. Cross court lane. Oh, man. The Jaguars with their hands in the air like you're supposed to. Keep your hands up and good defense by Horton to get him back. And Miles getting the chew. But I tell you, can't really stay mad at Miles because he just gets it done all over the court. Here we go. Horton. To McCaskey, Lane in the corner, wants it for three. Looks good. No. Did I call Horton Hopkins? There you go. Hopkins then, pardon me. Is that 12 or 14? Oh, 14 is Hopkins. There you go. Horton's 12, my bad. Okay, Hopkins, there you go. Say it louder. What's the matter with you? Here we go. Left side, Jack's turning, twisting, giving it back up top now to Reynolds. Reynolds will take it to the right side. Davis and the foul by Horton. Here comes Hopkins. Horton, here comes Hopkins. Hopkins, here comes Horton. Horton, here comes Hopkins. The first time Horton. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Hopkins, here comes Horton. Hopkins with the foul. Horton will have to take a seat. That's two on Horton. Who's the foul on? Look, they don't even know who the foul's on. And Byron is livid. Justifiably. Shots away, it's good. Davis. Now Hopkins will sit down. Horton will come in. Elijah Davis not here to keep me on track. And Omia Greer finally starting to put me on track. Want to send a shout out to Erica and Crystal. And the staff of Christina. She's a whole staff all by herself. Oh, and that's off the mark and snatching it down. It's Brian Miles. Miles gets it over to McCaskey. McCaskey skips it. Tulane over to, oh! And Miles with a beautiful reverse layup. Here we go. The Panthers just smothering the Jaguars. Like a lion on a zebra. Been watching the Discovery Channel. Davis for three. Off the mark, no good. Reynolds gets the rebound and just tries to muscle. And Reynolds, a touch foul. And that's going to be two fouls on Smith. He's going to have to come out. And then Horton is going to have to go back. Hopkins is going to have to go back in with Horton. I tell you, when you don't watch them in a week or so, they kind of really start looking all right. Reynolds at the charity stripe for free throws. The Jaguars coming in shooting from the charity stripe. 68%. The Panthers are a couple of points better, shooting at around 74%. Let's make sure here. Smith is going to have to take a seat. Hopkins is going to check back in, man. The Lady Panthers, folks, if you've just checked in, with an overtime loss to the Southern Jaguars, by 7, 75-68. I tell you, what a really, really, really good game. The Panthers put it together well. But just couldn't get it done. And the Panthers throw another one away. That's three turnovers for the Panthers here in the early going. You can get the live stats, folks, at www.pbpanthers.com. And gee whiz. Jax loses it. They're all over him. Jax travels, no call, down to 6 seconds. And it's taken away by Hopkins or Horton. No, that's McCaskey. Oh, good pass by McCaskey. Open out of Lane. Lane in the corner. Hopkins back out to Lane. Oh, deep three-pointer. Looked good. Looked like a really good open look for him, and he couldn't find it. Here we go, right side. Lane. Gives it over to Miles on the baseline, back out to Lane, and it's tipped. And Lane comes across to block him out. But no way. The Jaguars will have it right side. Deshaun Allen is checked in, number 13. Here we go, back right side. Davis for three, for two. No good, and coming down with it. All the Panthers. Horton to Lane looking for McCaskey in the corner. McCaskey just hanging around. Lane steps back, puts it up high. Man, wow, look how high Hopkins was. Trying to tip it back in there, and man, down to 12 minutes, 13 seconds left to play in the first. Jax has it at the top of the key. 15-12, a three-point edge. Now make it a six-point edge. Here comes Smith. Horton will have it now. McCaskey, we need some scoring. Smith is the only one hitting. Lane needs to turn around and bury that one. There we go. Charles Lane, no. And Reynolds nursing that right leg. Got a long, big brace on it there. And, oh, man, that was going to be off to the races. Miles couldn't handle it. And that's going to be the first media timeout here, ladies and gentlemen, here in the William Nix Center on the campus of Prairie View A&M University. The Panthers are down by 5, 17-12. Stay tuned. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button. Because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
We're back live here in the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. Just looking at some statistics here. The Panthers getting beat in the paint 10-6. You know, we talked about our big man play. We're pretty much a guard-driven team this year. But the turnover ratio, the Panthers giving it away 7 times already this half, and the Jaguars have given it to us 4 times. Right side, up top. Deep three-pointer. That time by Dejan Jumasi. 20-12. McCaskey can't find it. Gee, Willikers. Oh. Hopkins will take a seat. Here comes Lundley and Gazelius. Gazelius, the three-point specialist, really been quiet this year. And we're just waiting on his breakout game. Gazelius now in for the Panthers as well as Deshaun Allen for the Jaguars. And nobody blocking out. Brente Noel comes in for the putback, 22-12. The Panthers down 10 already here in the fourth. In the first period. And a foul under the bucket. Miles going with it. And the officials, 22. A foul on Tijan Jumasi. That's going to be his second personal foul. McCaskey trying to get the last minute instructions. 10:46, 22-12 the score. Here we go, right side. Smith finds a lane, gets it out to McCaskey. Great shot in the corner. McCaskey with the dribble drive, puts it back up and under. Oh, man, it just rolls off. And there's just a mad scuffle for it. The Panthers can't come up with it. Here we go back down the other way. Jax Anton on the left side. Jax up top to Noel. Noel, 6'10". He doesn't look 6'10". Mitchell loses it. Travels, no call. Nundley picks it up and is fouled from behind. And that's going to be a personal foul. Yeah, that's going to be a flagrant one. Now, they're going to look at this one and see flagrant one or two. They're going to look to see if it's one or two, or they're going to call it a flagrant one. Flagrant two. It's got to be a one, because if it was a two, he'd be going over there by that exit sign. And Nunley will get an opportunity to close the gap for the Panthers here. 10:09 left to play here in the first half. Nunley. First shot is way in and out, no good. Nunley's second shot is away. It's good. Well, he'll get one out of that. The Panthers will get the ball back. And let me see, where did my people go? 22-13 the score. McCaskey with it. Coming left side. Jax almost takes it from him. Golly gee, Willikers. They give it to the Panthers. Wow. Horton will come out and give McCaskey a break. Horton is just a freshman from League City, man. He's got plenty of time and plenty of talent here. Nutley. What? A foul, blocking foul on Horton. On Hopkins? No, on Horton with a 14 to 12. 12 was, oh, they give it to Horton. Oh, my goodness. That's just a ticky-tack foul. Hopkins will come in. McCaskey will come out also. Or Gazelius will come out. No, they're going to pull Gazelius and leave Nunley in with Horton is Byron Smith. Here we go, right side, back up top. Noel kicks it left side over to Jax. Jax wants to work on the alley cat. Nunley. Right side, wide open. Here we come around the right side with Tezano. Tezano looking right. Good defense by the Panthers so far. Davis working on Horton, pushes him and spins. No call. And the jump ball goes down towards the Panthers. .922 left to play. 22-13 the score. Panthers about 11. Says the second jump ball. Supposed to be the Panthers jump ball. Who is you got it? And here we go back right side. The Panthers get it. Here comes Lane. Lane brings it across the timeline. Gets it over now. To Horton, now to Hopkins. Horton to Hopkins, oh, with a reverse layup from the left. Ooh, that's nasty. And 7-point edge now. Right side with it in the corner. It's going to be Brandon Davis. Davis will kick it back out for a three-pointer from Allen. And, man, Allen with one of those deep ones. Left side, Horton comes up top the lane. Lane coming down the right side with a pass over to the right side. Is zero, or are they going to call four with the push? Brant Noel was out there. Okay, so they'll call Tezano. Tezano and Noel were both there on that right block with a push. Charles Smith will come down and take a break. The Panthers, or pardon me, the Jaguars with 17 fouls now in the bonus. Lane will shoot free throws. Thank you, sir. And with 8:31 left to play, the Panthers are down 10. Here we go with a 1-1. First shot is away. It's good. Lane with one more. And Nunley, boy, the Alley Cat and McCaskey can't wait to get in. And here come the two defensive guard tandem, McCaskey and Lane, will come out. Man, Byron doing a great job of substituting, but Byron can't get out there and play. That's one thing. Jax kicks it up, bad pass. The Panthers get it. Here comes Horton. Hopkins now gets it over to Miles. Miles with a big dunk. And now the Panthers trying to get up ahead of steam here. Here we come, left side. Jax gives it up now to number one, Jerron Wilkins, who's just checked in from Biloxi, Mississippi. Are the Wilkins brothers there? 13 and the other one, we'll see. Williams gives it up back now, right side. Jax kicks it over on the right side to Brandon Davis. Goes out of bounds, stays with the Jaguars. And the Panthers are down by 6 here. 7:48 left to play here in the first half. Ladies and gentlemen, 25-19 the score. Stick around. We'll be back with more. Back live here in the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. We're back live here in the William Nix Center. Did you catch that first? Okay. The Panthers, you got to remember the 45-second rule. We can only get down for 45 seconds. And when I say get down, we can only boogie and play our music for about 45 seconds before YouTube flags us. Okay. I've been a DJ for 50 years, so I think I ought to be able to play. Oh! Reynolds comes down and drops the shoulder, or is that Deshaun Allen? It's 13. Coach, if you sound, I can see. Lane will come in for the Alley Cat with some great defense. 7:45 left to play. Here are the Panthers trying to battle back into this one. McCaskey with a great... Oh, man, over to Miles. Miles with a reverse layup, and he's going to be fouled. Great job. Great passing. Great job from Horton to Hopkins, from Hopkins into Miles. And Miles will be smacked on the arm. And we'll be back. If you can throw Monday's graphic up, please. Monday's graphic, folks. Don't forget, coming up this Monday. Right here live in the Baby Dome, folks. Get that graphic up real quick. Here we go. It's the Pink Out game, the breast cancer awareness game, right here in the Dome. Folks, you can come out, wear your pink on Monday. And Kiki is going to wear pink also. Starting at 5 o'clock with the pregame show. Seven:30 left to play. Here we go back the other way. Jax, oh, man, with a great pass down to the middle, threading the needle over to Allen, man. Oh, man, for a three-point shot. He's hot. Deshaun Allen, the graduate student from Auburn Hills, Michigan, Greg Burks, putting it in the hole here. Here comes Hopkins, finds it in the left hand, and it's going back the other way. Got to play a little more under control. The Panthers are just kind of Harry Carey here. Jax brings it left side, kicks it back up top to Wilkins. Wilkins, oh, he traveled. Okay, that's a jump step. Okay, Wilkins comes back right side. Deshaun Allen turns around. Ooh, he's hot. Oh, Horton double dribbles. Well, the Panthers, folks, gonna have to kind of get it together is just not the word for it. You're gonna have to try to start playing some smart basketball, quit making all these gosh darn mistakes. Wide like that one. Wide open. Oh, and he misses a wide open play. They're going to call a foul, and it's going to go back the other way. Miles was pushed in the back. A push in the back. Jerron Wilkins. Oh, I guess they are changed. Jerron and Jayron Wilkins. Did you know that? You didn't even notice, did you there, Mia? Jayron and Jerron. Our twins.
Oh, I noticed that when it was right here.
Yeah, you thanks for telling your the big dog. I mean, I thought I was seeing double. 6:27 left to play here.
You didn't know that was twins?
No, it didn't. Shame on me. Should have did better homework. Miles at the line hits the first one. 8-point lead now. 30-22 the score. Second shot is away. It is good. What happened to the Here we go back the other way. Jax bringing it left side. Gives it up to Johnson. Johnson to Jax for three. Man. Horton working now on McCaskey. Hopkins. No. And they kick it right back out to Horton. McCaskey will slow it up, and there's a whistle. It hit the rim, so it should be a 30. Lane and Smith will come back in. Horton and Nunley will check out. What, did they take seconds off the shot clock, or what? What's the call, huh? 5:51 left. Here comes McCaskey. Coming down right side to Horton, over the lane, over to McCaskey, over to Hopkins. Now, oh man, beautiful play by the Panthers. That's textbook there. Jax. Working hard there on Hopkins. Here we go, right side. And that one's going to go out of bounds, yeah. Mung will check back in. And Tezano will check back in for the Panthers. Miles gives it up. To Smith. Smith can't hold it. Miles saves it in. McCaskey is going to throw it away. The Panthers with the turnover. The Panthers had 7 turnovers on the last break. Working on the live stats. They're not cooperating with us today. Jordan Johnson will check it out. Take it out, and it's going to go out of bounds, and the Panthers want it? No. Checking in for Prairie View, man, sneaking in Justin Nimmer, the graduate student from DeSoto, Texas, 6'6", swing man. Jax will have it up top, 18 seconds on the shot clock. Jax comes around on the right side, puts it up, looking for the cross from Davis. Davis brings it around the right side. Oh, he's grabbing the shirt, McCaskey. Here comes Nunley. Going around Nunley. Oh, man, Nunley with some great defense. Down to 3 seconds, 2 seconds, one. Ah, and McCaskey with the foul, bailing Southern out with 2 seconds left on the shot clock. Great defense. He said, I tried to do too much, coach. What can you say about that? 20 seconds on the shot clock. Jordan Johnson, the sophomore from West Palm Beach, Florida, will take it out for Kevin Johnson. Two very spirited coaches, to say the least. Byron Smith and Kevin Johnson. We just let them go at it at half court. That should be fun. Davis back up top now to Jackson. Jackson will run the point guard down at 7 seconds. Nunley on him like a glove. Oh, they give it to Mung. And Horton will commit the foul. Miles will come back in along with Lane. Nunley will come and take a break. Folks, at halftime, we'll run our spots and thank all of our sponsors. We'll come back and maybe let you see a little of the halftime. We'll show you the Panther Dolls, but the Pantherettes didn't get a chance to show them. So do we have time, our engineer? We'll see. We'll throw it all on Woodlawn, James Crenshaw. Here comes Nunley. And McCaskey's going to take a seat here. 4:32 left to play. Nunley will get it. And here come the Panthers in the first half. Nunley running the point. Brings it to the right side. Over the Lane. Lane finds a lane. Slips it right in there. And Nunley in the man of the land of the Giants gets the rebound. Here comes Smith with the turnaround. Yeah, that's nice. Charles Smith the fourth with a big shot there for the Panthers. 36-27. The Panthers need to stop here. And they're going to give that one to Nunley. Nunley riding him like the trail ride is today. On Monday, the Prairie View A&M University Trail Riders come to town in the annual Chili Cook-Off right here on the campus of Prairie View A&M University. Should be a lot of fun, folks. Here's the replay. And, well, I guess we won't see the replay, folks. Stick around. We'll take a break, folks, a quick break, and come back with more exciting Panther basketball right here on the original one, Prairie View University Panther Sports Network.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The key word being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
Back live here in the William Nix Center. Okay, some stats here. Really interested to see the points off of turnovers. The Panthers with 10 turnovers. Southern actually with 10 turnovers. The Panthers with 12. The points off of turnovers. Yeah, Southern leading 15-11. The Jaguars also winning the battle in the paint 16-14. And second chance points with 6. Off the bench, they've got 20. The Panthers only with 2 points off the bench. Man, we've got to do better than that here. At the line, shooting free throws is going to be Jax. the Jaguars here in the first period are 5 of 7 from the charity stripe, shooting 71%. And now the Panthers down 11 again. 39-27 is the score. Nunley right side to Lane, back up to Smith. Smith to Hopkins. Hopkins over to Miles. Miles with a turnaround jumper. Yeah. From 10, it's good. Miles with three double-doubles in a row coming into tonight's contest. Right side with it. Back up top. Davis with a deep three-pointer. Double dribble, no good. And ain't nobody grabbing the ball. Here we go. And they put it back up, and there's a foul call. Is that going to be against the Panthers or Jags? What's going on? They're going to call that one against the Panthers? 30? I'm going to call that one against Nunley. Oh, come on, man. Golly. Got to do a better job of getting in there. McCaskey up off the bench for the Panthers. Down to 3 minutes left to play. The Panthers down 10. 39-29. And going to the bucket is going to be Jordan Johnson, the sophomore from West Palm Beach, Florida. Be his first trip to the charity stripe. And the officials having a chat. Is this the one and one? Are we shooting one and one, or are these going to be two foul shots? It's going to be one more we're shooting, too. So we're in the one and one. All right, here we go. Johnson. At the line, free throws away, no good on the one and one. Miles snatches it down. McCaskey will skip it over to Hopkins, and Hopkins will break the defense down on Southern. Here we go, Hopkins right side, kicking it back up top. McCaskey gets it, kicks it back in the corner now. Lane has it. Hopkins playing around the perimeter. Smith with the turnaround jumper, no good. Nobody there on the right side. Rebounding. Dung puts it up off the backboard. No good. McCaskey to Smith. Smith puts it back up. No good. No fouls call. Oh, golly gee. Here we go back down the other way. Tizano has it, kicks it in the top now to Brandon Davis. Davis comes around and it rolls in. 2 minutes left to play here in the first half. The Panthers down 12. Smith off the glass for two. Gazelius up off the bench. We'll catch that one down a minute 40. Mung. And a timeout on the court. And a quick 30-second timeout. While we've got a minute here, exciting Panther softball is just around the corner this Wednesday. We want to congratulate our preseason superlative, senior Viviana Figueroa, Kaylin Massey, and Mia Nunez, all on the first team, all conference. Garcia, the center fielder, go get it, Garcia should have made it. And also on the second team, man, our second baseman should have made it, at least the second team. Come on. Come on, man. But we're really happy for all of the ladies. Destiny Smith, the shortstop, who comes from a dynasty of softball shortstops. Her mama was a shortstop. Her great-grandmother was a shortstop before they started making stops. So I can't wait to see them. They're coming down to watching in the Talley family from Oklahoma, somewhere in Oklahoma. Aaron. And, man, Horton. Well, I thought Horton was going to jump in there. Hopkins took the brunt of that one. Man, McCaskey gets it across the timeline, right side over the lane, back up top now. Wide open in the corner. Here's Gazelius. Gazelius, man, hadn't really gotten any good shots, getting good looks. And, oh, my goodness, we just throw that one away with a minute left to play. We've got to go in and rebound here at the halftime. Allen for three. That's too long. And snatched away and taken away by McCaskey. Good job. Here comes Horton Hopkins off the glass. Oh, yeah, coast to coast with that one. I like it. And a timeout here. Well, the Panthers now have cut it down to eight. As Nunley gets ready to check in, we'll take the final media timeout, or is this going to be a 30-second? Look at this, folks. Great move there by the Panthers. Here's the replay. Oh, thought we were going to the replay. Nope, not this time. Folks, don't get excited. Panther basketball returns on Monday with the breast cancer awareness game. The pink out game, ladies and gentlemen. I want to make sure that you get out here for that one. It's going to be a lot of fun. Jada Roberson donning the breast cancer awareness flyer. That's going to be this Monday, February 19th. The women play at 5:30 to tip off. Pregame show starts on the Splendid Media Network at 5 o'clock. We jump right on over here at 5:30 and pull all those people from Splendid on over here to Panther Vision. Man, we've been getting some outstanding views, and we just want to thank all of you so much for supporting exciting Panther sports right here on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network. Down to 35 seconds. Tezano has it. The cross is over on Lane. Lane's going to be called for the foul on the floor. Well, that's 10, so that's two shots. We'll be shooting two. Both teams in the penalty going down the stretch. Jaguars were shooting 80%, or was that Prairie View? The Jaguars were shooting 71% at the last break. Shot is away, it's good. Davis will come back in, and Charles Smith, the fourth, will come back in. Shot is away, it's good. McCaskey gets it across the timeline down to 22 seconds left. Lane playing for the last shot, 43-33, a 10-point edge. Shot is away, it's good. And with 4 seconds left to play, the Panthers cut it to eight, ladies and gentlemen, here in the William Nix Center. 43-35 to score. 43-35 to score here in the William Nix Center. Folks, stick around. It's halftime. We'll go to our studios for a break and come back with exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View A&M Panther Sports Network. It's my
empire, and yes, I call it. HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Hey, Don. What made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button. Because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here, and changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gaughan. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab, because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button. Because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
At Prairie View A&M University, excellence isn't just a word, it's a way of life. For 147 years, we've been empowering generations of students to carry our rich legacy of distinction with them as they blaze trails and make a difference in communities across the world. Our high-caliber faculty and rigorous academic programs prepare scholars to challenge the status quo and push the boundaries of knowledge. Pioneers emerge here. And changemakers are bred here. Excellence lives here.
Panther Nation, this is your athletic director, Anton Gaughan. I just want to take a few minutes to talk about the importance of giving. Whether your gift is big or small, it's important to our student-athlete success. Your donation will help us increase our Panther experience for our student-athletes. It'll increase our competitive excellence as well as our academic excellence. So please join me in visiting pvpanthers.com and click on the Give tab. Because this is where champions are built. Thank you.
Mic check. Mic check. JT Barrett here at the Baby Dome. Halftime, Fairview A&M down 35-43 versus Southern. As you can see here, our halftime stats. Fairview shooting a whopping 61%, but still down right now by 8 points here. Heading into the second half, Southern right now putting on a performance. 65% from the field, 55% from the three-point line, and out-rebounding and out-assisting the Prairie View A&M Panthers as well. Right now, Southern shooting 72% from the free throw line. They are 8 of 11. Prairie View is shooting 80% from the free throw line. They are 8 out of 10. The biggest difference in this game right now is going to be that three-point percentage, though. As you can, well, you can't see, but right now, Prairie View has only taken 2 3-pointers here in this contest, while Southern, 5 of 9 from the three-point line. That is the biggest difference. We'll be back with Charles Porter on the other side of the break. This is Panther Vision.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Hey, Don, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button. Because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. Halftime score, 43-35. The Panthers down by 8, man. Could have went down by 6, but just didn't get the ball out in time. So the Panthers now will have 20 minutes to try to get this one back in hand. 8 points, not a big deficit here. I think we can get it done. And we've just got to play some great basketball and play some good heads-up basketball. Not try to make as many mental mistakes. The Panthers, 15 turnovers for Southern. The Panthers with only 11 turnovers off the bench. The Panthers only had got 2 points off the bench. 2 points off the bench and 22 points off the bench for the Southern Jaguars. Panthers with second chance points at 6. And we're tied at 18 points in the paint here. So the Panthers doing a little bit better job here coming down in the second half. 19 minutes left to play here. 43-35. Left side with it. Lane will have it and drives to the left side with a 20-footer. Steps in with a double pump. Misses the shot, and we're going back the other way. Coming down with the rebound is Tezano. Moon with it on the right side. Kicks it over to Jumasi. Jumasi kicks it back up top to Wilkins. Wide open that time under the bucket for an easy shot. That time was Davis. Nunley couldn't get back on time. He'll run the offense for the Panthers. Hopkins at the top of the key. Brings it left side. Hopkins to Smith. Smith puts it in for 2. Wilkins, right side. Smith takes it away. Here comes Hopkins. Puts it up with the left hand. And now the Panthers cut the lead to 5, folks, 45-39. Moon comes back right side. Down low, Moon puts it up, easy one off the glass for 2. Moon is a freshman from Frankston, Australia. Lane, now to Nunley. Smith loses it, and with a reach there is Javon Wilkins. McCaskey brings it left side. Turn and twist and finds Lane with a double pump. He's fouled. Oh, my goodness, no call. And we're going back the other way. Jumasi comes right side, throws it over to Dung. Dung turns around, puts it in off the glass with 2. It's easy. Mm-hmm. 17-18 left to play. Lane to McCaskey. The Panthers having it rough here. Not going to get any easier next week when on Monday. When Gramlin comes to town. Left side, McCaskey's pushed. Lane bringing it to the right side. Lane has his shot blocked by Moon, and we're going back the other way. Tezano loses it, and here come the Panthers. Take care of the ball. Hopkins to McCaskey. Smith just kind of hanging around. Right side with it, skips it down on the baseline to Miles, and Miles is fouled by Moon, and we'll go back the other way. Miles going to the free throw line. Miles perfect from the free throw line in the first half. 4 for 4 to shoot 100%. Miles with 10 points and 3 rebounds in the first half. I can't believe that statistic. 3 rebounds for Miles. And I know I counted at least 7. But I don't do the play-by-play in the computer, so gee whiz. Miles coming off 2 back-to-back double-doubles in Florida. Shots away, it's good. He's perfect from the free throw line. 16-29 left to play here in the first half. Or second half, folks. Jumasi brings it to the right side. And Jumasi and Nunley. He's grabbing Nunley's hand. He's grabbing Nunley's hand. Run that one back, and let's see who's grabbing whose hand right here as we get ready to bring that one in here. We'll back it up a little bit, and we'll see who's grabbing whose hand. We don't have it? We didn't get it? Didn't get it, folks. We'll apologize. Well, Southern will have the ball. Jumasi gets it in to Mung. Mung wants to work. Back to Jumasi. He's got a wide open shot for 2. Left side with it. Smith throws it out to McCaskey over to Hopkins. Down low to too many passes. Gee whiz. Will somebody shoot the ball? Jumasi coming left side. Brings it, spins, turns, Dung over the right side. Man, Davis for good. And a timeout called by the Panthers. Well, 15:38 left to play. We're going to stretch that one out to the media timeout, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers down 13, 53 to 40. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. 53-40 the score. The Jaguars up by 13. The Panthers, man, losing a lot of second chance points. 6 of 5 with second chance points. 15 turnovers for Southern, 14 for Prairie View. They're beating us in the paint by 6, 26-20. But the staggering statistic is the bench points. 21 points off the bench for the Jaguars of Southern University. 14 rebounds to 8 in tonight's contest. Right side with it. Lane gets legged whipped by number 4. Yeah, that's going to be Derek Tizano. And now here is the full timeout, ladies and gentlemen. 15-24, ladies and gentlemen. 15-24 left to play. 53-40. We'll take a full timeout this time, a full timeout, and come back with more.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Hey, John. What made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, folks. This Monday, coming up at 5:30 p.m., more exciting Panther basketball comes your way as the Panthers take on the Tigers of Grambling State right here in the Baby Dome. Ladies and gentlemen, the pregame show starts on the Splendid Media Network at 5 o'clock. And tip-off is at 5:30 right here from the William Nix Center. You can catch all the play-by-play in color right here on the Prairie View and them YouTube page. And Hopkins is tripped. Noel will take it out. He's from right there in Baton Rouge. He's a homegrown kid. So I'm sure he's probably got a huge following right there in Baton Rouge. Here we come right side to get it down to Noel. He wants to work on Miles. Noel turns, spins, loses it off of his leg. They're going to call it down there, but it looked like it went off of his leg. They're going to call that one off of Byron Miles. If you look at, look here, it comes down low. Noel turns, spins, and loses it off of his leg. Who do they say they went off on? Lane? Okay, Lane's over there close. 12 seconds on the shot clock. Quick pass in the right side. Great hand that time by Horton. Jumasi to take it out all the way up top. Way up top. Oh. To Tezano. And Jumasi ran right over McCaskey. Oh, come on, ref. Gee whiz. Here we go right here, folks. Look, now here's the first foul. Now look at it in slow-mo. Great push. Look at the push. Come on, man. He pushed off with his arm. Wow. Easy bucket there for Tezano under the board. But after that, degrading play, gee whiz. Smith for three. Doesn't hit it. Byron told him to shoot it. He was wide open, couldn't hit it. Jumasi working on Hopkins. Comes around the left side, step back from Davis. Boom. Southern's getting hot now, and the Panthers are just having it rough. 18-point lead now, folks. And the Panthers are just throwing it all away. Gazelius. Got off the bench past Coach Smith. Smith said green light. That means he can do whatever he wants. And he can shoot at any time. And we're going to keep it down on our end. Gazelius and Lane will check in. Gazelius has the green light. Miles will come out with Smith, and they'll both take a break. McCaskey, right side. Gazelius, Lane from deep three-point land, no way. The Panthers have their three-point shooters in. Lane, well, Smith needs to be in there. Rebound, Lane. Kicks it over to McCaskey, and here we go across the timeline, looking left side. Hopkins wants it, gets it. Back out to Lane. Lane wants a deep three-pointer. Miles sits down. Here comes Lane. Oh, wow. Smith right back in it. Lane's going to get a break. Nunley's going to check in and probably give Horton. Hopkins getting after it. McCaskey with it now from the turnover from Gazelius. Oh, and a nice one up and under for McCaskey, and here comes Hopkins. And Horton here on the play scoops it up for two. McCaskey will have one shot to try to complete the one and one. McCaskey from right down the street in Missouri City, Texas. Shot is away. It's complete. 43-58, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers now down by 15, trying to eat into this lead. I want to send a shout out to my main man, Eric Juarez. Saw Brandy in the store the other day, and I think, where did I see Brandy? She was excited about the season. So you got the best cheerleader, sports information dad in the world, and Eric Rojas. And I also want to send a shout out to my teammate, Michael Urban. Tell everybody to watch the games, Michael Urban. We're putting together some initiatives with all of the teams. This is what we're going to do here on March 4th when Alcorn comes to town. The four-peat champion Lady Panther basketball team and a foul called on Smith. Smith battling over there with Jerrion Wilkins. But while I got a second, let me tell you quickly. We'll be honoring the four-peat championship women's basketball team. Started with Cynthia Cooper. She started the dynasty. Three championships for Cooper. I think it was three. She had an odd year. Came back, won again, left. Then Toyel Wilson took over as coach, won two in a row. And when she left, then Don Brown, a.k.a. Diva coach, came in and won another one. So that was four in a row of four-peat. And we're going to celebrate then the 10th anniversary, 10-year anniversary of that four-peat is this year. Jeanette Jackson and crew. If anybody's seen Larissa Scott, I am looking for Larissa Scott of the Prairie View A&M University women's basketball team. Larissa Scott, hit me on Facebook. Or heck, I don't care. 361-251-3314. Looking for Larissa Scott. We are trying to get all of the team together. So for those of you who are Panthers who know Larissa, know somebody know Larissa, she's from right here in Cypress. Know her cousin, her mom and them, whatever you got to do. Just give them that information so that we can get in touch with her and honor them properly on Saturday, March 4th, I think that is, right here in the William Nick Center. Now, talking with Greg Burks, we're going to do the same thing for the men. All of the championship teams, all of the teams, and we're going to get this. We're going to get our roster together, and we're going to be calling you. Set the date and come for senior night. All basketball players, all women's basketball players are invited to senior night. We get in free? No, just the honorees. But you know, you should be buying season tickets. Every basketball player, every football player, that's able, should be buying season tickets. Some of y'all are buying foul. I knew that was going. They were pushing. McCaskey, I had to stop my statement. McCaskey and Diamasi really going at it over there. A lot of people buying stuff that just don't count. You know, you ever go in a dollar store and just buy stuff you don't need because it's a dollar? But that's kind of a lie because the dollar store ain't just a dollar no more, is it? 12-10 left to play. Another, while we got another mention, I had one of our alums, I guess, mentioned that I was an annoying announcer. See, I talk about everything but the game. I beg to differ. Jax for three. Wow. But I thought people want to know what's going on. 40 years, he don't count. 24 seconds on the shot clock. Oh, it bounces up and down. You know who you are, BT. Yeah, that's your initials. Should I do it? Shame on me. And, ladies and gentlemen, well, there's a timeout on the court, BT. We'll take a break and let you take a listen. All right, shame on me. Stick around. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network.
You can say what you want to say about me.
There you go.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
With Academy Sports and Outdoors, you can take outdoor fun to a whole new level with just the touch of a button. Because there's so much to discover on the Academy app. Create your dream outdoor living space that gets the whole family out there spending time together. Master new recipes with just the right amount of heat and the perfect spice or seasoning. And give the kids even more ways to play. Great times are waiting. Download the Academy Sports and Outdoors app today.
Welcome back to the William Nick Center, ladies and gentlemen. Charles Porter coming to you solo tonight. The Panthers taking on the Jaguars, man, 63-45. The Panthers really just they came out great. I mean, with a lot of emotion and fire. Still not over yet. The Panthers have Hopkins on the line. Shot is way too short. For those of you listening on the Panther Sports Network, we want to thank you. Almost close to 15,000 views in a little bit more than 30 days. Looking for 20,000 views. Looking for 30,000 views for the spring. 30,000. We'll put that in, and that'll be with the football, volleyball. We'll put those in, and trying to get 100,000 views a year. So we got off to a slow start, but I think we can at least get 50 before the year's over with softball and baseball and track. So, folks, keep sharing, keep watching. Go back and watch our YouTube page as many times as you can. And Giamasi picked up some Samsonite, which they don't even sell Samsonite. Well, you can get Samsonite fixed. Yes, they do. I've got this black bag with Samsonite. But nobody knows what Samsonite is but me. Guess I'm showing my age here. 11:34 left to play in this one, man. The Panthers having a hard time with Southern University. Smith spins. Gets it out to McCaskey. Over now to Lane. Lane left side to McCaskey. Out to Hopkins down. Oh, great pass to Miles. Beautiful pass. Man, where has that been all night? Miles is going to be called for the foul. Two on Miles. Up top now with it, Giamasi. Comes left side. Oh, man, the moon for an easy dunk. Nobody's blocking out, folks. Here's some finals for tonight. Alabama A&M, a winner over Valley, 64-61. Alcorn State gets Bethune-Cookman by 11. Pine Bluff, man, just takes it to Alabama State, and a hard one to the bucket is Miles. Miles. Coming Horton. Reynolds comes in. Reynolds, a big kid there, a big bruiser. Southern defeated our Panthers by 8, 68-75. Florida A&M just beat up by Jackson State, 71-44. They're the big bully. Coming up this Monday schedule, Alcorn State will be taking on Florida A&M. Alabama A&M welcomes Pine Bluff. Alabama State will take on Valley. Bethune-Cookman visits Jackson. Prairie View will entertain Grambling, and Southern will skip on down 290 to Texas Southern. That's the scoring games on Monday. One thing, my grandson, Cameron Hayes, and his dad were coming out and supporting me. He was on the team, but we had to make some adjustments. He wasn't hitting enough free throws. And here we go. McCaskey tries to thread the needle, and Reynolds pushes McCaskey from behind. He'll get the foul on 21, and we'll go back the other way. And Kevin Johnson is really, really livid. And up top with it, Hopkins. From Horton, McCaskey, left side, finds a lane. Drives, puts it up, has it blocked. Oh, McCaskey, oh, wow. McCaskey said, I didn't touch it. And it's going back the other way. There's a block. .949 left to play. The Panthers down 15, folks. Want to send a shout out to Jeffrey Jernigan Sr. Another fantastic basketball player here at Prairie View A&M. Still praying for you, my brother. Here we go down the right side with Davis to slow it down. Davis, and something's going on. A technical foul on Jumasi. And Jumasi's technical foul. Jumasi getting about to get a chew from Johnson. Shot his way, it's good. McCaskey, Horton, and Hopkins come over and get a chat from Byron. Lane shot his way, he hits, yeah. Okay, so 51-65, 13 points. 52, I'm sorry, thank you. So what's that, 12-point lead? 13-point lead, 52-65. And the Panthers still got a lot of time. Not a lot of people in foul trouble. I think we get some stops here, we'll be okay. Reynolds up off the bench. .65-52, the Panthers with it. McCaskey brings it left at the top, trying to find Lane. Yeah, Smith for three. Boom, yeah, Smith puts it in softly for three. Now we're at a 10-point lead. Manageable, very manageable. As Jumasi brings it down on the left side, goes around McCaskey, throws it in the corner, wide open. It's Jax for three. It's off the mark, coming down with it is Smith. Kicks it out now to Horton, over to Hopkins. Oh, man. Good job, man. I wish that was reversed and Hopkins would have had the fast break, because I tell you, Hopkins would have jumped that, dunked that. Here's the three-pointer from Charles Lane, Smith, man. I tell you, he's got a real smooth stroke, folks. Miles with it inside, now gets it over to McCaskey. Right side, oh, and the steal from Tizano, and Tizano slips on some perspiration over there. And the Panthers will keep it with 29 seconds on the shot clock, 8:46 left to play. The big dog coming to you solo. Mir Greer has left the building, folks. So it's just me and you, kid. Folks, don't forget this Wednesday coming up, exciting women's softball kicks off right here on the campus of Prairie View A&M University. The two-time champion Lady Panthers will be taking on North Dakota State. Panthers kicked their season off last weekend in the, I think that was the Incarnate Word tournament. They took on Lee, they took on Buffalo, and Incarnate Word. Tell you, they were on Incarnate Word's posterior. The comeback just was too much. No fouls there. I don't believe it. Oh, wow. Not only do I not like it, but the crowd don't like it either, man. Gee whiz. Well, tough call. Left side. With it. Jax with it up top. Jax going around the pick set by Reynolds, trying to get it down to Reynolds. Reynolds gets, yeah, man, Reynolds gets Hopkins behind him and a talk because he said a bad word. I saw him. Yeah, y'all need to. The technical foul on number 12. Smith will go to the line, and he better be careful else he'll be going to the locker room here. Let's go back and see if we can see that, folks, if we can see him getting thrown to the ground. Okay, here's Jax. Jax, and look down in the middle. Now, there it is, right there. Go, can you back it just a little bit? Can you just go back? Go back just a little bit. Here we go. Now watch him get thrown to the ground. Stop it right there. See, catches his neck. Stop it right there. Now here we go in slow-mo. Off the pick. Reynolds sets the pick, right? And we're stuck. Reynolds sets the pick right there. And you see him grab him around the throat and throw him to the floor. That's going to be a technical foul. And then he said, he displayed a couple of pleasantries. And that resulted in a technical foul here in the William Nix Center. Everybody's looking at it. Well, folks, we'll wait to see what the officials come up with. I think it's a technical foul for sure. Well, a foul for sure, and then a technical foul. The Panthers with six team fouls. The Jaguars already in the bonus with 8:03 left to play. Down the line, the Panthers, if they play their cards right, will have it down. Here it is again, ladies and gentlemen. Look down here on the right side. There he is, grabs him around the neck, puts it over. That's on purpose. What do you think? Here we go. Common foul. Common foul on number 13, and then a technical foul, I think. Okay. Well, we'll see what's going on here, folks. Just want to make sure we're calling it right. I think it's going to be a common foul on 13 Reynolds, and then a technical foul on Reynolds' rebuttal. Can we call it a rebuttal? Yeah, we'll call on Reynolds' rebuttal, all right? 8:03 left to play. They're going to – first shot is away. It's good. 56-65. Now the lead cut down to 9. Same thing happened in the women's game. You're absolutely right. The women – Jaguars were leading by 11. The women came back and cut it to 4. So it's 2 technicals and a Class A technical foul. So, and we'll get the ball back. And we'll get the ball back. So, man, this is a 6-point turnaround, a 6-point turnaround over a mistake of just a little bit more aggressive play than needed. I'll just say it like that. Here's Smith's last shot as well. Oh, he hit 3 out of 4. That's okay. And the Panthers will get the ball back. I like it. 65-58 now, back to a 7-point lead. What can the Panthers do? Hopkins. Right over now to Charles Smith. No. And here comes the Jaguars. Right side with it. Here comes Jax. Jax coming around the left side trying to find a wide open Brandon Davis. Davis back to Jax. Jax comes around right side. He traveled. No call. No traveling call. In and out, no good. Dang, it's a mad scuffle for it. Miles chasing it down. Here comes Miles getting it over to Charles Lane. Lane coming left side. Over now to Horton. 58-65, still a 7-point lead. Horton. And a reach, ladies and gentlemen. A reach in and a foul call. And when we come back, the Panthers will be at the line shooting free throws, ladies and gentlemen. 7:01 left to play in this one. The Panthers are down by 7, 65-58. Stick around. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Hey, Don. What made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU's all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
Looking at some more stats, man. The Panthers are doing a little bit better now. In the paint, they're cut it to 4. They were tied at 18, but 26 points in the paint for Prairie View, 30 for the Jaguars, man. 17 turnovers by the Jaguars, 23. The points off of turnovers, well, it doesn't have that there. Point off the turnovers. Okay, the Panthers with 17. The Jaguars, okay, I got it right. The Jaguars with 17 points off the Panthers turnovers. The Panthers with 23 points off of the Jaguars turnovers. The Jaguars with 16 turnovers. No, check that, 21 turnovers. And the Panthers with only 17. So putting it back in is good. Now the Panthers are within 6 now. And here we go, folks. This one's going to be another barn burner like the first one. 6:59 left to play. Jax has it at the top, working on Horton. Left side, with it is Jax, brings it to the right. Hopkins, and there's a reverse layup, it's good. Here come the Panthers. Quick one down the right side. Here we go down to Lane. Lane stops, spots for three, it's off the mark. Nobody there to get the rebound. And Lane is mad because Lane didn't wait for any help. All right, we need some defense now. 6:17, still a lot of time left, ladies and gentlemen. Allen to Tezano, back to Allen. Allen's got the three-point trigger. And here we go back to Jax. Jax looking left. Crosses over, goes around Moon. Down low, they lose it. And the Panthers get the ball back. Here comes Hopkins. On the wing, Horton gives it up to Smith. And we turn the ball right back over. Golly. Jax brings it out. We'll go back to the same scenario. Jax brings it right side. Gives it to Allen, to Davis, to Jax. Davis right side in the corner. Allen's got the three-point trigger. Davis will take it, though, for three. Hits the side of the iron, no good. It's tipped and knocked away. Miles snatches it down, kicks it out over now to Horton, and will slow it up. 15-19 left to play, 67-59. The Panthers need a score here. Here comes Horton, stops, spots. Here comes Hopkins with those big super jumps. Puts it up, gets his own rebound. Oh, man, we got to have every possession counts. 5 minutes left in this one, 67-59. Coming right side, Jax with it. Gives it up and a hand check or a timeout. Timeout. Wow. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the Panthers here. Are they going to make it a full timeout? Yeah, we're going to take it to a full. Will it be a full timeout or 30? Okay, they're going to keep this one at 30. While we got a moment, folks, I want to remind you that this Monday, exciting Panther basketball continues right here in the William Nix Center as the Panthers take on the Tigers of Grambling State. Wednesday, more exciting Panther sports coming your way as the Panthers take on who are the North Dakota? Are they the North Dakota Mountain Goats? What is North Dakota's mascot? We'll see. Well, the Panthers are getting ready to take the field again. North Dakota, let's see. North Dakota State, they are the Utes. If I had Mia back here with me. Bison, they're the Bisons. North Dakota Bisons. Okay, there we go. Left side with it, Davis. Dung. Hopkins posting up Dung. And here we go. No way. And shot clock violation. We'll go back the other way. The Panthers got away with a foul, by the way. And rightfully so. And 67-59. Still got a lot of time in this one. Still got a lot of time to get this one going here. 4:33 left to play. Here comes McCaskey at the top of the key over to Miles. Miles coming left side, gives it up to Charles Smith. Smith coming to the left wing. Now back to Hopkins. He thought about the dribble drive. Hopkins getting him now on Jumasi. Tries to put it in the middle. And we turn it over. Trying to draw some fouls here. The Panthers are shooting two down the stretch here. The Jaguars with 10 team fouls. Davis comes around the left side. Davis steps back. Dung working on Miles. Dung setting the pick. They try to get in front of Miles. McCaskey with the great cutoff. Down low, and they're going to call McCaskey with the foul. But, man, he's running all up his chest, ref. Wow. Look at the replay here. Now, that could have been the first foul. Okay? So they get it away. Davis, or Tizano rather, running all, is that Davis? Is that 10? Yeah, Davis running all into the Panthers, and we just can't stop them here. Media timeout here on the court, ladies and gentlemen. Media timeout. Stick around. We'll take a break. Come back here. 3 minutes, 49 seconds left to play. The Panthers down 67-59. We'll be right back.
HBCUs are anchored by legacy. They nurture the talent and determination of their students and prepare them for a bright future. The Home Depot's Retool Your School program has and still believes in the excellence of HBCUs, committed not just in speech, but through the revitalization and upgrades of the campuses these students call home. Building, planting, tilling the dream, all hearts and countless volunteers on the ground. Retool Your School. We're powered by purpose.
Welcome back to the William Nix Center, folks. 3:49 left to play, 67-59 the score. Man, the Panthers have an opportunity. It's not over yet. I think if we can get some good stops and try to bring some clamp down defense into play, I think we'll be all right. Going to the charity stripe to shoot free throws is going to be Brandon Davis, the redshirt senior from LaPlace, Louisiana. Hutch, they're from LaPlace, but I just like to poke fun with them. Their grandmother, Hutchinson's grandmother, listens in LaPlace, Louisiana. I've been saying that they're from all kinds of places, the Ninth Ward, Algiers, West Bank, Studiewood, and that's in Houston. No, I'm just teasing. Here we go back the other way. McCaskey back on top, coming back right side. Here comes Charles Smith, puts it up. Oh, man, has it blocked by Mung, and we'll go back the other way. Wow. Davis brings it left side, looking inside, finds a man, Tizano, with a turnaround jumper from 15. Ooh, buries it. Man. Wow. 3 minutes and 9 seconds left to play. Here comes Horton. Coast to coast, puts it back up. He's going to be fouled. We'll go to the line for two. Nunley is going to check back in. Lane will take a seat. -69, a 10-point lead. Golly gee. That's just 3 three-pointers. Hopkins with the first free throw, it's good. You cut this lead down to 8. With one more shot. Hopkins at the line with one more. Shot is away. Oh, yeah, baby. Now the Panthers down by 8. We need some defense. Come on, Panther fans. What y'all doing? Y'all don't want to win? Okay.
Y'all ass home.
2:53. Here we go around the right side. Jumasi working on Nunley. Davis, rather, working on Nunley. The alley cat goes through the pick. Here comes Davis. Double pump. Oh, they're going to call a foul on Brian Miles, and he got him with the body. Golly. Oh, they call that one on the alley cat? Oh, wow. There was more of it here. Just check it out, ladies and gentlemen. Here comes Davis on the drive. Davis brings it left, goes around Nunley. Oh, and Nunley got him from the other side on the arm. Yeah, he did. He got him, coach. Yeah, he got him, coach. Got it from the other side. Golly gee. 61-69. Davis is a 61% free throw shooter. Let's just call it an arbitrary number to try to jinx him here. Davis at the line to shoot free throws. Now he heard me, so now he's really concentrating. Puts it up. Didn't work. All right. We'll just jinx it. He's a 41% free throw shooter. We're just calling out arbitrary stats, and we made him miss. Want to send a shout out to Sonya Perry. Hey, Trill. And the next shot is way. Oh, and we didn't jinx him that time. And now it's back to a 9-point lead. Here comes Charles Lane. Hopkins is going to check out. Well, Horton is going to check out. Man, golly geez. Y'all stop it. Hopkins with the super jumps. The super hops is in. Now McCaskey will have it on the right side down to 2:35. We're nearing crunch time, folks. 9-point lead. We need to score here. McCaskey coming down the right side. Oh, there's a lane. Couldn't get it in. They're trying to get it to Smith. Smith's got the hot hand. Smith on the dribble drive. Thought about it. Almost lost it. Gives it back out to Miles. Miles looking left, looking right. Spins. Turns in the lane. Puts it up off the backboard. Oh, Miles with the Dr. J take there, baby. I love it. And a timeout called here. The final timeout of the contest here. The final media timeout here in the William Nix Center. 2:13 left to play. Here it is again. Let's look at this spin. Great shot. Miles takes it, crosses over, spins on Mung, and puts it up with the right hand. Man, that's a shot there, ladies and gentlemen. That's a shot. Stick around. We'll be back with more exciting Panther basketball and an exhilarating finish. Ooh-wee. We'll be back with more.
Hey, John, what made you become a Cricket Campus Ambassador?
Do tell.
I live to network. HBCU is all about that. The keyword being network.
Oh, like a certain network that has speedy 5G and is a proud sponsor of HBCUs?
I see you can take a hint.
Mm.
I can drop a hint too, Don.
Live here, and we're back live here in the William Nix Center. 2:13 left to play, ladies and gentlemen. Man, the Panthers are down by 7. We've still got enough time here, folks, to get out of here with a win. The Panthers are going to have to just play some good heads-up basketball, get a couple of stops here, and most of all, sink shots. Now, the difference is the Panthers, the Jaguars are in the double bonus. So every time the Panthers are fouled, they've got 10. The Panthers got 2 fouls to give here with 2:13 left to play, folks. It's set up for an exciting finish. Here we go. Amen. 13 seconds to crunch time, folks. Here we go. Mung puts it in. The Panthers now with the pressure. Mung tries to get it away to Davis and now over to Jumasi. Jumasi there on the left side working on McCaskey. McCaskey trying to work through the pick. Here comes Jumasi. He has it knocked down. Miles got all ball. And Miles, gee whiz, man, with the punch here. Here's the foul. Here's this great camera work. Now check it out. In slow-mo, Jumasi goes around the left side. McCaskey fights through the pick there. Goes around the right side. Miles picks him up. And Miles gets him on the arm. that's the great camera work that we got. Shame on you, Woodlawn Entertainment, for being so good and just outing us when we commit fouls. couldn't dispute that. Well, I'm sorry, folks. I'm with you, Panthers, but, man, great camera work. Folks, those of you who are looking at us and listening to us on the Splendid Media Network, all you got to do is go back to the YouTube channel. Go back to www.prairieviewpanthers.com. You can do it a couple of ways. If you go there, you can go and click on our schedule. There are 3 dots. They call it the hamburger there on the right side. When you go down to the schedule and you click that, you're going to either get the live stats or that'll take you straight to our YouTube channel. Or just go ahead and bookmark it on the YouTube channel. Smith. Oh! Charles Smith with a big dunk. Finds a lane. And puts it in for the Panthers, man. Great pass by McCaskey right there, ladies and gentlemen. Look at it. Oh, man, got you done. Wow, he's hung. Here we go back now down on the Jaguars side. 1:25 left to play. The Panthers down by 7. The Jaguars trying to run out the clock. We're going to have to foul somebody, just not him. 11 seconds on the shot clock. Diamasi puts it off the glass for 2. Wow. Down to 1 minute left to play here in this one. 101, 1 minute now left to play. Here comes McCaskey from 15. He'll put it up. That's an easy one. 67-74 now. A 7-point lead. We need to do something. Jumasi says, get on down, I'll take it. And he wants to hold the ball. There's the last 44 seconds. Here we go down to, and it's going to be a flagrant foul on Miles. Miles just with a hard foul, not just a flagrant. Three is going to be a flagrant, 1 or 2. Are they going to look at it? Well, here we go. Miles grabs it, goes up, comes, grabs him around the chest. Doesn't throw him to the ground, but does grab him. That looks like a flagrant one to me. And then, they'll get the ball back. Didn't throw him on to the floor, just grabbed him around the top torso. And gee whiz, 31 seconds left to play. Man, both teams, I thought, fought real hard with some very, very good basketball teams. Tezano misses the free throw. Tezano with 1 more. Shot is away, it's good. They'll get the ball back here now, 75-67, an eight-point lead. And we hope to talk to Byron Smith after this one. Here we go. Juamasi will take it out and call a timeout. Draw up another play. And we'll take our final timeout here, ladies and gentlemen, of the contest, folks. 31 seconds left to play. We'll be right back with more exciting Panther basketball. Welcome back to the William Nix Center, ladies and gentlemen. Come on, hop on this love train, baby, and support Prairie View A&M University Athletics. Got a lot of initiatives going, coming real soon. Season tickets are on sale. All you got to do is go to our website, 350, 250, and 150. And if you are a season ticket from last year, you got, I guess, about 60 days to reclaim your seat. If you've got a Clinton, and don't quote me, but I think around around May 31st will be the last day, and a trip, the last day for you to get your season ticket regular seat. So if you've got a seat that you've been having, I think you got a couple of months. We'll say May 31st. I think Miss Addison said May 30th. May 31st will be the last day that you can reclaim your season ticket seat. So you got March, April, and then May. You got 3 months from today to claim your seat, or else we're going to sell it. That's just what's going to happen. We won't be waiting until the last minute. We're trying to sell 2,000 season tickets. We don't have that many chairback seats, but if we sell 2,000 season tickets this year, the AD told me we're going to get 2,000 chairback seats. What do you say about that? Okay, so won't you be a part of the group that purchases enough seats so that the Panthers' season ticket seats will be 2,000? You do the math. And you know I'm an advocate of paying your money because I've been paying mine for a long time. Don't just come to homecoming. Here we go down to 27 seconds left to play. Oh, man, Davis is going to just run it out, folks. I mean, the Panthers down to 18 seconds and Lane is going to foul Juamasi and go to the lane. It's spelled D-I-O. Well, he's from France, but if you look at it, it looks like Diamasi. Like Diamasi and Demontron. It was Diamasi and Demontron Buick down in River Oaks back in the day before Biz began. Well, folks, don't forget, tell a friend to tell 10 friends to tell 10 about exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View A&M University Panther Sports Network. All our games are streamed and posted on YouTube. So you can go to the Prairie View A&M University Athletics YouTube channel. You can go back and watch the game as many times as you want. In fact, we encourage it. The more views we have, the more money we can get. And that time, Javon Wilkins grabbed a hole to McCaskey. Should be two shots. Allen will check in. Wilkins coming out. Hopkins. Shot is away. Yeah, it rolls in there. Shot is away, and it's good. Down to 9 seconds. And that's going to about do it, ladies and gentlemen. Wow. 6 points. The Panthers lose by 6 points. The men and women's team both lose by 6 points. Is that deja vu or what? Well, folks, Panthers had a rough time of it. We're going to try to get Byron Smith over here and chat with him. Not always real easy to get Byron over here after the Panthers have taken the L, but let's see. After the school song, we'll stop trying to get his attention over here. And folks, we'll pause and stop for the playing of the school song right here, ladies and gentlemen. We'll let you listen. This is the Prairie View University Panthers Sports Network. Ladies and gentlemen, the Panthers had it rough. Byron Smith is going to come over here and chat with us here for just a second, ladies and gentlemen. Wowee. We're back live here with head coach Byron Smith, man, a tough one, coach. Man, gee whiz, man, it seems like we're just right there, and every time we get close, the Panthers, man, we just don't have enough. A six-point loss, man, we were right there in it.
Yeah, right there. Yeah, tough one. We thought we were very well prepared. Some guys didn't really, step up. They kind of got out of it early, mentally. Mm-hmm. A few guys didn't really bounce back, so makes it kind of tough on you. But we fought, gave the best best effort we could give, really wanted to win, but sometimes your best not good enough.
You know, Coach, we seem to be getting so close. We just got to get in the tournament. I think if we get in the tournament, we're going to shock a lot of people. McCaskey and the Alley Cat coming off the bench have been doing really, really, really good. We've coined Nunley the Alley Cat. And you need to go back to that same alley and see if you can't find a few more of those. Maybe he has some brothers and sisters lying around trying to get here. But I think the Panthers, man, are just right there. I think we're really finally falling into sync. Miles is just a beast. Five rebounds, that's malarkey. He had more than five rebounds. You kill him with a double-double. We at home. We got to go check that. I think Lane and Smith are doing well, but Hopkins just didn't get the game that he usually has.
No, he wasn't in it tonight. I'm really disappointed that he let, not getting offensive opportunities and not getting fouls called early just kind of took him out of his game. So, you know, he's a fifth-year guy. You know, he has to be more poised, and he has a lot of experience. So that was quite disappointing tonight.
Well, Hopkins only with 14 points, 5 assists. You know, we need 18 from him. You know, we need more than that. I mean, Horton's got to get back involved into it, but I think Brian Miles is man, just a beast, man. He's the best big man in the conference, if you've asked me, and I'm not just saying that because he's here. Yeah. He does everything you want him to do, and he shoots great free throws. So, Coach, as you get ready to go back to the drawing board, I know you got to hurry. What do we do to get prepared for Monday?
Just got to come back and follow the game plan. Our back seems to always be against the wall. No different. We've responded the last 3 weeks when our back's against the wall, the must-win game on Monday night against Grambling.
Well, you know, I went back and looked at some of our interviews, and we always think our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ as we started, and we're going to get back to what we were doing because that's what was working. And, man, we just want you guys to get back. We hope you guys can turn things around here. It's not over yet, Coach. You still got some time, baby. It ain't over yet. It's not over yet. And we're really excited about it. Coach, thanks a lot for stopping by. I know you got to get to your guys. Don't get them too bad, Coach. Yeah. Don't get them too bad, Coach, because I know I want to be a fly on the wall, Lorenzo. He said he couldn't wait to come back to the – he said, Danny, ask Coach if I can come to the locker room just one more time.
Absolutely. Anytime. Always welcome.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to wrap it up for us here in the William Nix Center. Coach Byron Smith and myself, your staff and your team are doing a good job, Coach. You just got to stick with it.
Thank you.
And we behind you 1,000%. I know because we got 1,000 people watching us. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that wraps it up for us here in the William Nix Center. Don't forget, coming up this Monday, more exciting Panther basketball as Breast Cancer Awareness Game is Monday. Wear your pink. Wear your pink on this Monday. It's Breast Cancer Awareness Live here from the William Nix Center. We invite all of you to come, especially you survivors. And then also on Wednesday, exciting women's softball, G-Boom. Get started right here in the right here on the campus of Prairie View A&M University. The Panthers take on North Dakota State, the Bison. I want to thank all of everybody who made this possible, especially our friends over at the Scorers Table who do such a fine job for us. Deandra Kidd, Candace Bennett, and Shari Gilbert. That's not the Scorers Table. Oh, well, we'll get them on Monday. How about that? They did a great job, Maddie and the whole crew. Who always do a great job for Miss LaTanya Thurston. For Athletic Director, Mr. You have it over there. Thank you. I gave him. Let's go ahead and give them their kudos. Marquise Brown, who's the shot clock operator. Joshua Simmons, who's the game clock operator. Justice Ward, the scorekeeper. Miss LaTanya Thurston, who's a statistician in the play-by-play documenter. Miss Kiki Williams, our spotter. Rick Godfrey, our PA announcer. And Noah Jackson, our stream innovator. How about that? We'll see you on Monday, ladies and gentlemen, with more exciting Panther basketball right here on the Prairie View A&M University. Panther. Baseball tomorrow? I'm sorry. Minute Maid Park. That's right. What time? 3? Okay, folks. Pardon me. Thank you, G-Boom. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, the Panthers are playing in the HBCU Cactus Jack Tournament in Minute Maid Park down. We play Alcorn tomorrow at 4 o'clock. 3 o'clock. Alcorn at 3 o'clock. Thank you, Ms. Thurston. Tomorrow, if you're not doing anything, get on out and support the Panthers. We'll be there. It's going to be a lot of fun. Don't forget, exciting Panther basketball and softball coming your way this week. Okay, do I have everything now? Golly gee, I've been trying to sign off for the last 5 minutes. For our athletic director, Mr. Anton Goff, our assistant athletic director and senior women's administrator, Ms. Alicia Pete, our sports information director, our boss, Ms. LaTanya Thurston. It's been Charles Porter, Woodlawn Entertainment, Rick Godfrey, and the whole crew saying so long. We'll see you Monday with more exciting Panther basketball. Good night.